Hi everyone. I had a few requests for a tutorial for the instrumental version of Take On Me that I uploaded a couple of weeks ago, so I thought I'd give one of those a go. It's if you haven't listened to the version that I recorded, do have a listen before you try this tutorial, because the arrangement in that version and the key are both different to the original one, so you won't be able to play along to the original one. Although if you do get used to it, the key of the original is only up two semitones, so you can use a capo on the second fret, shift everything up to two frets, and you should be at a better place to play along. There are three different sections, each is repeated once, that we're going to put in this version, so we'll go through those each in turn. First we'll look at the chords that we use for each section, and then we'll look at how we layer the melody over the top. So the three sections are the intro, which is the bit that's like, there's the verse, which is the bit that's, and there is the chorus, which is the bit that's like, those are the three sections. We start with the intro, then we go verse, chorus, and then we use the intro as an outro. That's my arrangement. It's to say it's different to the record, and you can do whatever you like with it. So the intro, the chords we're going to use for this are A minor, which is fretted on the G string on the second fret, and all the other strings open. We're going to use two D chords, so we're going to use this one where we barrier across the second fret, and then we also fret the fifth fret on the A string. And we're going to use another D chord that's higher up. So it starts on the ninth fret, where we fret on the C and the A strings here. And then on the E string, we fret on the 10th fret. So it's the same shape. If you know the G from down there, it's the G shape, but just shifted all the way up here. And I usually wrap my thumb around, because we're gonna mute G string. We don't want to play that in this chord because it doesn't fit. We could play it there, but we're going to need all our fingers because we're actually doing melody and stuff on top. We're also going to use a G chord that is here, so that's barriering across the seventh fret, and then using our little finger on the 10th fret on the A string. I'm going to use that one, G, and then we're going to use an E C chord here, which is open on the G and C strings, fret the E string on the G, and then the E on the, I'm going to sound an E on the A string on the 7th fret. You could in theory play it just like that, but if you've seen any other tutorials I've done, I usually say that you want to avoid doubling the third on a major chord. For some reason it comes up in every tutorial, so I will tend to use that version. If I want this E in the chord, I'll make sure that I fret here and don't have two E's in a major chord. Doesn't count for a minor chord, different rules. So we're going to use that, and we're finally going to use another G chord, which is open G, second fret on the C string, third fret on the E string, and the fifth fret on the A string. So those are the chords we're going to use for this section. So we're going to layer a melody on top of that for the intro. So when we're playing the A chord, we're going to reach up to this E, which is the 7th fret on the A string, for that first note of the chord. So then drop down to the C whilst we're keeping the A minor shape. So that C is on the 3rd fret of the A string. Okay, then we go to our D chord, we hit, make sure we hit the top note of that twice. And then up to our higher D chord. And I tend to slide from the G to the A there, just to get it feeling a bit more fluid. If you try and pluck them both, it tends to get a bit bitty. So I tend to just slide them. And then to our G chord. Again, strum it twice. Or three times. And then down to the 10th fret on the E string. And then open on the same string. And then to our C shape. And then our G shape. And use the little finger to go up from the 5th to the 7th fret for that. So I'll play that all the way through really slow. That's the intro. Then we go into the verse, and we're going to use our A minor chord, but we'll start with it with the C fret at this time. So we're going to fret the 2nd fret on the G string and the 3rd fret on the A string. We're also going to use a D chord. We're not going to fret it all the way up though, because we're going to need that open A. So we're just going to fret that on the 2nd fret for the G, C, and E strings. Here. You see, I'm not fretting that one. Depending on how big your fingers are, you might do that individually with your fingers, or you might actually, I just tend to bend this finger across like that. we're just going to use our G, open G, but we're not going to play the 5th on it, we're going to play the 3rd on it. So that's G, 2nd fret playing a D on the C string, G on the E string on the 3rd fret, and a B on the A string, 2nd fret. So there. We're going to play a C chord as well. So we actually first play it there, but we go up to there. The other chord that we'll use in the verse is an E minor, but we only play that once towards the end. We swap it in where we'd normally play the G. So those are going to be the chords that we'll run through for the verse. We run through those 3 times, and then the 3rd time we swap in the E minor, which is open G, and then 4th fret for the E on the C string, 3rd fret on the C string, giving us the G, and a B played on the A string on the 2nd fret. We're going to use that one as well, and we do that one last time round in place of the G, so it'd be... Normally, and then on the last time round, we're going to do. That's a normal one. And then the final time we're going to do. Okay, and we'll put the melody along with that. So, the melody is going to start on our A minor chord, and we have this C at the top. Okay, and then we switch to our D chord, and we keep that A open. can see that's open there. Then we go to our G chord, and normally I bounce onto the top note of this. It's a nice little effect, you don't have to do it. You might want to maybe use it a little more sparingly and use it to add a bit of variation. I tend to throw it in quite a lot because I like it. So I actually play the chord first with both the G and the A strings open. And then on the A string, without plucking it again, I just hammer on with this finger. And then back down to our C. But I'm only going to play these three strings here. And then go up to the E on the seventh fret. And then to the G. So we swap to our G chord, but we leave this E above. So it then resolves down to the D on the fifth fret that would normally be there. So. So the second time round, we were slightly different at the end. So instead of going up here to the E on the A string, we're going to go from this G on the E string to the A and the B. Being careful that we don't pluck this string, and I've got this one kind of muting it. So this finger is also fretting this string, but it's also muting the one above it to stop me hitting it by accident as I'm doing all this. Okay, so. Then third time we go. So we're actually, when we go from the A minor to the D this time, we're actually keeping our C pressed down at first. And then I take it off because the sung note ends there. And that actually changes that D from a straight D to a D7. Then to the E minor chord. So we sound the chord, but we're not actually going to use this note at the top of it once we've sounded it, because the melody actually takes place underneath it and we don't want to crowd the melody out. So we'll sound the chord and we can move down to the E string where we're fretting the G on the third fret, and then we take everything off apart from that, and still we're only plucking these bottom three strings. Go down that final run to get us into the chorus. So the verse is, to recap. We'll do that again, we'll do it slower. And then the final part is the chorus. And the chorus is going to use a G chord, a D chord. So we've seen this G chord already. This D chord we've seen already. And we're going to use a different E minor chord. We're going to use this one here, which is open on the G string, fourth fret on the C string, giving us our E, G on the E string on the third fret here, and then another E at the top of the chord. Use that one. And then we're going to go down to this C chord here that we've seen before as well. We have these bottom two frets open, and then third fretted G on the E string and the E on the A string on the seventh fret. We're also going to use this D chord that we've already seen. This one that's on the ninth and tenth fret in the same shape as an open G, but just moved up. And we're also going to use another form of E minor, which is open G, E on the C string, B on the B on the E string on the 7th fret, and then the 10th fret gives us the G on the A string. And then we're going to take it even higher with a C that's open on these two frets, but then is on the 10th and 12th frets on the A string and the E string. And the final chord we're going to see here is a really high G. So if you know the G that's here, where it is open on the G string, second fret on the C string, third fret on the E string, and fifth fret on the A string, I'm actually going to take that up 12 frets, up an octave to hit that really high mortar note that they throw in. Okay, so to work out how that goes with the melody, first time we go through, we're going to play our G chord, but we're only going to play the bottom three strings. We're going to leave this one first time around. Then to our D, and then our E minor. And then for the C, we're actually going to first play it with the fifth fret on the A string. So that's a D. And go up and down to the seventh fret to our E in back. So we play that once, we then do the same thing, but the second time we actually play the full G chord at the beginning. And then the third time we do our G chord. Then we do our D chord, which is the same shape, but just slid up so it's on the ninth and 10th frets. And then our E minor chord. And then the first time round, we're going to play that low. So we're going to go to our C chord down here, and then go up to the 5th and the 7th frets and back down on the E string. And then to our G chord, D chord, and then we're going to keep this note going, because it's the singer holding that note going as long as he can. So go, and it's in our first two chords. We're then going to play an E minor chord, but we're going to leave this note here on the fifth. It wouldn't normally be there, which gives it a nice minor seventh feel. And then we go to our C chord, but we leave that D on there as well for a nice ninth feel. So going through the chorus as it would be the first time we play it, be. Okay, I'll do that again, even slower. Okay, and then the first time you played the chorus, that's going to go back into the verse that we've already seen. But the second time you play it, instead of going down the bottom, we're going to go to those high chords that we looked at earlier. So the second time you play the chorus, when you're going to go into the outro afterwards, it's going to... It's going to go slightly different. We're going to go up to that high C, which is open on these two strings, and we're on the 12th fret on the, oh sorry, the 10th fret on A string and the 12th fret on the E string. And then we're going to, on this top string, on the A string, up to the 12th, 14th, 12th, 10th. And then we're going to go to our high G chord, which is on the 14th fret, open on the G, 14th fret on the C string, 15th fret on the E string, and the 17th fret on the A string. If your ukulele doesn't go that high, just play it down here. No one will call you out. So... And then once you've hit that chord, back down to our sequence that we had before. And those are the three sections. I'll play that one again, this going high up real slow. And those are the three sections. It goes intro, verse, chorus, and then we use the intro as an outro. Check out the arrangement that's on the original video to see how it all fits together. I hope that was useful. I hope that covered everything that we need to. I didn't go into detail on the strum pattern. I figured once you've got the notes in the right place, you can figure that out for yourselves. But if you have problems, let me know. And if there's anything else you want to see me do a tutorial on, give me a shout. Thanks very much.